Hi, I'm Barb Nangle. I'm the founder of Higher Power Coaching and Consulting. I want to welcome you to my podcast, Fragmented to Whole, Life Lessons from 12-Step Recovery. On this podcast, I share my experience, strength, and hope from recovery. I don't support or endorse any particular 12-Step Recovery Fellowship, and I don't claim to speak for any of them either. My hope is that you will find my words helpful in some way, whether you are in recovery or not. This is episode 74, Privacy versus Secrecy. Recently, I was talking with a sponsee who had gifted a sum of money to one of her adult children, who I'll call A. She said A had never cost her a dime, had paid their way through college, came up with their own down payment for their home, etc. And their other child, who I'll call B, had been in and out of trouble. My sponsee had used money to get B out of trouble and rescued B financially, etc., and was grappling with what would happen if B found out that she had gifted this large sum of money to A. We then had a conversation about the distinction between privacy and secrecy, which she found to be really helpful, so I thought it might be helpful to others as well, and that I'd share it here. I touched on this briefly in episode 28, where I talk about the difference between things that are healthy versus unhealthy, which, by the way, has to do with your motivation. Why are you doing whatever it is you're doing? If you want someone to think a certain thing of you, for example, that you're generous, that's not so healthy. But if you're doing something like giving money to someone because it makes you feel generous and you like that feeling of generosity, that's healthy. Now back to secrecy versus privacy. When something is secret, it is typically because there's some kind of shame around it. We don't want people to know this thing because we think there's something they're going to think about us that we don't want them to think about us, and it will make us feel ashamed if they think that. So if they know this secret thing, it will cause us shame. Things that are private have more to do with healthy boundaries. Privacy has to do with what we choose to share with people and what we choose not to share based on what feels like personal information for us. It could be because it makes us feel safe, because we think it's no one's business, or any number of reasons. When we were having this conversation about her giving the money to A as private information as opposed to secret information, she had a really hard time understanding the difference. And that's because she's still learning to have healthy boundaries. Once people are good with boundaries, it's much easier to understand this distinction between secrecy and privacy. It was news to her that her personal finances are nobody's business but hers. It's not even her children's business. This is true for all of us. Your personal finances are no one's business but your own. Now, if you're married to someone and the two of you have some combined finances, or if you have a business partner and you have some combined finances, this is not true for those combined finances. Those combined finances are their business, but the rest of your finances are nobody else's business unless you choose for them to be. For my sponsee, there were several boundaries here to consider. One, her financial situation, including her financial decisions, are none of her children's business. Two, her relationship with A is none of B's business. This was also news to my sponsee. And therefore, the fact that she gifted money to A is none of B's business because neither her finances nor her relationship with A is any of B's business. And then three, the same is true for B, who she had previously rescued, saved, and bailed out financially. None of that is A's business because her finances are private, as is her relationship with B. Unfortunately, when she gifted the money to A, she didn't understand all of this, So she said to A, "You know, B has cost me all this money all these years, and you never cost me a dime. So it's my pleasure to gift this money to you." That stuff about B costing her all this money was none of A's business. That was private information. But at this point, it's too late. She already said it. So now let's go back to the question that started this whole conversation. What if B finds out that she gave the money to A? If this happens, she has choices for how she wants to handle it. If she truly believes that it's none of B's business, as I'm saying here, things will go much more smoothly for her. She could say, "That's personal and I'd rather not discuss it." Or, "It's really none of your business what I do with my money." Or, "I'm not comfortable with the idea of explaining my financial decisions to you." If she chooses to, and the operative word here, or the operative concept is choice, she could say something like, "That was a personal decision, but now that you've asked, I'll tell you, I spent lots of money over the years on you, on X, Y, and Z, and I never spent that kind of money on A, so I thought it was only fair to give that money to A as a gift." Now, how B responds to that information, if that happens, is also none of my sponsee's business. I want to reemphasize the idea of choice in this matter. We get to choose what we consider personal information and what we don't. There are plenty of people, some of whom are listening to this podcast right now, who think it's perfectly acceptable or maybe even important to share their personal finances with others. That's their choice. You get to decide how you're going to live your life and what makes you comfortable and uncomfortable, what you want to keep private and what you want to share with other people. It's nobody's business, and nobody can tell you what's okay and what's not okay to share. This is what boundaries are about. But again, in making this distinction between what's private and what's secret, it has to do with your motivation. If you are keeping information from someone because you're afraid of what they'll think, that's secrecy, and it's to hide your shame. But if you're keeping information from somebody because you feel like it's personal and private, that's completely different and has to do with a boundary. So the distinction really has to do with how we feel about the situation. We get to decide what makes us comfortable and safe in our own life, and nobody else gets to tell us what that is. Everybody's boundaries are different, and you will have different boundaries with different people, and you will very likely have different boundaries over time. For example, in the early part of life, many of us struggle with finances and might not want anybody to know. But then as we get older and better at managing our finances and have a handle on our financial life, we might be fine with people knowing about our financial history, especially if we can be helpful to them. And I'm a perfect example of this. In 1999, when my student loans came due, I ended up declaring bankruptcy because I couldn't handle the student loan payment on top of all the credit card debt I had racked up. I was completely ashamed of this and was absolutely not going to tell anybody while it was happening, "Hey, I'm going through bankruptcy." I felt ashamed because I should have paid back my debts. I now realize that I didn't learn how to manage my finances, which is how I got into that situation in the first place. And in fact, it was the second time I had racked up credit card debt. So as a result of the bankruptcy, I went about educating myself and taking responsibility for my finances such that I turned my financial life around, and 9 years later, I was able to buy a home. Now I'm fine with sharing this information with people because I'm no longer ashamed. When I share this with people now, they can see that just because your life is a mess right now doesn't mean it's always going to be that way. And just because you see somebody as successful now doesn't mean they were always that way. This is what maturity is: learning from our mistakes and growing from them. It's also what recovery is about: learning and in many cases unlearning things that we used to believe and things we used to do, then learning new beliefs and new behaviors. It's also what I've dedicated my life to through my coaching and consulting business. My job is to help people develop new beliefs, skills, and abilities so they can truly change and have a better life. And I know it's possible because it's happened for me many times over, and it's happened for my clients as well. I hope this distinction between privacy and secrecy has been helpful to you. When I started understanding this difference, it was really helpful to me. If there's somebody in your life that you think needs some clarity on this distinction between privacy and secrecy, please be sure to share this episode with them. And if you're not already following me on Instagram at Higher Power Coaching, I hope you will. Have a great week. That's it for today. Please share this episode with anyone who might find it helpful. If you like what you've heard here, you might be interested in private coaching with me. If that sounds like you, then head on over to barbchat.net, or you can get on my calendar for a free 20-minute consultation to help you make lasting changes in your life, like I've made deep, lasting changes in my life. My ideal client is someone who is ripe for change, but I'll coach anyone who wants to be happy, joyous, and free. So if that's you, then go to barbchat.net and get on my calendar. I'd love to chat with you. Please like and subscribe to this podcast on your favorite podcast outlet. This helps other people find me. Thanks for listening.